Deutschland, Deutschland, über alles.
Germany, Deutschland, a country whose past involved many periods of aggression against countries in the late 19th and early 20th centuries. What were those countries, and what was the final outcome following the end of World War I? Those are the topics I will present through the postal history of these countries during this time period. Hello, I'm Pat McNally, and it would be my pleasure to take you through this area of philatelic history. I've been a longtime instructor of worldwide history and art appreciation at the college level, and since the 1960s, a specialist of the postal issues of Germany and its empire. So let's begin. Following the creation of the German Empire after the defeat of France in 1870-1871, 2 decades of peace followed. During that period, under the rule of Kaiser Wilhelm I and the Reichskanzler Otto von Bismarck, Germany experienced significant economic, industrial, and military growth. With the ascension of the new Kaiser Wilhelm II in 1888, friction in international relations resurfaced. Kaiser Wilhelm II envied the might of the British Navy and bemoaned Germany's lack of stature and colonies. Rivalries emerged between Germany and the great powers of the world. Incessantly, the Kaiser pursued his imperial ambitions. Free or open trade became the mantra of imperialistic powers in the 1870s until challenged by the newcomer, Germany, in the African region. A conference held in 1884, Berlin, promoted by Otto von Bismarck, helped Germany expand. The conference literally carved up Africa, due in part to the discovery of quinine as an anti-malarial drug. Germany was emerging as an industrial power and wanted to be in the raw materials game. As a latecomer to imperial expansion, Germany had limited success on the world stage. Nonetheless, in the early 20th century, the rise of Kaiser Wilhelm II became the traveling emperor, challenging Britain, France, Italy, and Russia wherever possible. The ship Hohenzollern became a common image for his stance, namely a saber-rattler with very little diplomacy. Administration of empires, however, required money, staff, language training, trade experts, physical offices, diplomatic relationships, and a military presence. Germany found itself lacking in many of these. Despite these limitations, German trading establishments soon proliferated in Africa, Asia, and Oceania.
I'll provide an overview of the stamps and postal history of these overseas locales of German imperialistic ambition before World War I. A caution is warranted, however. Due to their popularity, large number of these issues have been counterfeited and or cancel forged. Other considerations beyond forgeries that complicate their study are paper varieties, color varieties, reprints, and overprinted provisional issues by Allied occupation forces. Colonies involve physical possession of geographic areas, while offices were transplanted German postal facilities in countries with which Germany had negotiated for expedited mail services to the empire. Let's begin with a quick overview of the worldwide post offices and colonies of the German Empire as it rose to a world-class power.
Prior to 1914, Germany established post offices and colonies in 3 regions of the world: Africa, Asia, and Oceania. In Africa, offices were established in Morocco and in the colonies of Cameroon, German East Africa, German Southwest Africa, and Togo. In Asia, Germany established offices in the Ottoman Empire and the offices and colonies in Eastern China. In Oceania, Germany established colonies in New Guinea, the Caroline Islands, the Mariana Islands, the Marshall Islands, and Samoa. Germany used 8 stamp designs throughout its colonies and foreign post offices. One is a unique oval design released in one value, issued in 1875, in all foreign post offices and colonies, with the exception of the two colonies in China. The second was of the Reichspost Krone und Adler design, also known as the Crown and Eagle series, released in six values in 1889 for the use in all foreign post offices and colonies, with the exception of the two colonies in China. The third was of the large Reichspost design, released in four values in 1900, and used in all foreign post offices and the two colonies in China. The fourth was of the Germania design, released in 10 values in 1900, and used in the offices of China, Morocco, and the Ottoman Empire. These four designs can be found as and referred to as Vorläufer stamps, which are German stamps used in the colonies and foreign post offices prior to the issuance of the country or colony-specific releases. They can only be identified by the cancellation town or city name. The fifth was of the Deutsches Reich Germania design, released in 10 values in 1902, and used in the offices of China, Morocco, and the Ottoman Empire. The sixth was of the large Deutsches Reich Germania design, released in 4 values in 1902, and used in the offices of China, Morocco, and the Ottoman Empire, and the two colonies in China. Beginning with the Hohenzollern issues, colony-specific inscriptions become the norm. Wilhelm II's yacht, Hohenzollern, started the colony-specific series in two sets. Both sets were released in 1900. The first of the series is a small design issued in various values depending on the colony and were used in all of the colonies. The second of the series is a large design issued in multiple values and currencies depending on the colony and used in all of the colonies. During World War I, Allied invasions occurred throughout the German colonies. In several instances, German stamps were overprinted by occupying forces. These will be handled separately in their appropriate discussions for the affected colonies. In some cases, the invading Allied forces, rather than overprint captured German stamps, elected to overprint stamps of their own respective colonies. These are not discussed in the presentation. Let's begin by looking at the countries in Africa where Germany first focused its colonial ambitions. Morocco, a country at the entrance to the Mediterranean Sea, was one such country. In the latter part of the 19th century, it consisted of separate areas under Spanish and French control. Due in part to Morocco's instability, Germany established post offices in many cities of this country. Economic interests induced Germany to compete with France and Spain in major cities like Tangier, Rabat, Casablanca, and Marrakesh, along with many lesser cities. When it opened its post offices in 1899, Germany used stamps that was overprinted. Since the German post offices had distinctive issues from the first day of postal operations, there are no Vorläufers known for Morocco. The Reichspost 1889, the Reichspost Large, and the Germania issues were the only issues used. In all, 58 stamps were released. Stamps were issued, both with and without overprinted values, in peseta and centimos, and using Latin or Gothic fonts. Morocco was spelled two different ways, M-A-R-O-C-C-O and M-A-R-O-K-K-O. Examples of postally used German Moroccan stamps are plentiful. Locating postal history is more difficult to find. German post offices were closed in French-controlled Morocco in 1914, and in Tangier in Spanish-controlled Morocco in 1919. Germany established routes in Cameroon in 1868 on the estuary of the Wuri River, where the city of Douala is now located. Later, Gustav Nachtigal concluded a treaty to annex the region for the German Emperor. Germany claimed the territory as the colony of Cameroon in 1884 and steadily pushed inland. The Germans encountered resistance from native peoples as well as the British and the French. Commercial companies regulated local governments under the laissez-faire administration of Germany. They relied on forced labor, primarily focused on banana, rubber, palm oil, and cocoa plantations. With Germany's defeat in World War I, Cameroon became a League of Nations mandate split into the French and British Cameroons. They merged into the single nation of the Cameroons in the 1960s. Philatelically, the Cameroon began with stamps known as Vorläufer. In all, 25 German stamps were used, consisting of 6 Reichspost values and 19 Hohenzollern values. The British overprinted 13 Hohenzollern values featuring the initials CEF for Cameroon Expeditionary Forces. The French overprinted their own colonial stamps, which are not covered here. German colonial postal history exists, but is generally quite scarce. German East Africa was in the African Great Lakes region that comprised of what is today Rwanda, Burundi, Tanzania, and the Kayanga Triangle, which is now part of Mozambique. It was approximately 3 times the area of modern-day Germany. The colony began in early 1885 when an adventurer arranged treaties with several local chieftains. The Sultan of Zanzibar protested, claiming that he was the ruler of both Zanzibar and the mainland. With the threat of military action by the German Navy, the Sultan was forced to concede. German rule was quickly established along the eastern coastline. To promote commerce and economic growth, Germans created plantations of coffee, rubber, cotton, and sisal. Sisal became their largest cash crop. Germany's control of the colony ended with its defeat in World War I. However, German resistance led by General Leto Vorbeck continued until 1918. With the end of the war, the mainland came under British rule as a territory of Tanganyika, with Rwanda and Burundi regions going to Belgium and the Kayanga Triangle going to the Portuguese. The territory of Tanganyika gained final statehood as Tanzania in 1961. Throughout the time of the German East Africa colony, regular issue Reichspost stamps were used and Vorläufers exist. The first postage stamps of German East Africa were released in 1893, overprinted in peso values. These were used until 1896 when the stamps were overprinted with Deutsch Ostafrika on a diagonal. In 1900, Germany issued the Hohenzollern Common Designs, denominated in pesos and rupees, and inscribed Deutsch Ostafrika. 64 pesos equaled 1 rupee. In 1905, Hellers replaced pesos with 100 Hellers to a rupee. Germany continued to print stamps during the war, issuing a 1 rupee watermarked Hohenzollern in 1916. Genuine uses of this stamp are extremely rare. In 1915, the Allies blockaded German East Africa, which stopped the supply of official German stamps. With the dwindling supply of postage stamps, the Postal Administration produced facsimiles of 5 of the small Hohenzollern series known as the Karasimbi Provisionals. These facsimiles were not intended as true forgeries, as they are so different in design quality and size that they could not possibly have fooled users. Imperfect copies exist. The captured facsimiles were used by the British forces and overprinted with GEA, British Occupation. Also, these facsimiles were overprinted with forged cancels. British overprints exist only on these five facsimiles. Belgium, India, and Great Britain issued overprints on their respective colonial stamps, which are not covered in this presentation. By 1916, the German Postal Service was discontinued as a consequence of Allied occupations. In all, a total of 41 stamps were issued for German East Africa. Postal history of German East Africa is not difficult to find, although it can be somewhat expensive. Mafia Island is an island off the east coast of German East Africa and a district in what is today Tanzania. Germany took control of Mafia Island under a treaty of 1890. In January 1915, the island was captured by British troops. With the occupation of the island, British forces began using captured German East Africa Hohenzollern stamps with several different overprints using black and violet inks. Overprints included hand-stamped GR Post Mafia, GR Post Mafia surcharge with 6 cents, and a handwritten overprint GR Mafia, JDM, which was issued by Governor Lieutenant Colonel J.D. Maclay. By the end of July 1915, the stock of German East Africa Hohenzollern stamps were exhausted. The British then began using German fiscal stamps, overprinted OHBMS Mafia, in a circle. These fiscal stamps can also be found with an overprint of GR Post Mafia, either by itself or combined with a OHBMS Mafia overprint. These fiscal stamps were used until stocks of Indian IEF stamps became available. Virtually all Mafia Island postal history was created by military personnel for the philatelic trade. This does not discredit their legitimacy, but clarifies their origin. Most postal history is addressed to military personnel. Many have never traveled, and some are heavily overfranked. There is little civilian mail known. German Southwest Africa was a colony of the German Empire in southwestern Africa from 1884 until 1915. In 1883, a German merchant established a trading station at the Bay of Angra Pequena, which was later renamed Lüderitz Bay. Under the belief that Britain was about to claim the area as a protectorate, the German imperial government, in August 1884, proclaimed the area as a German protectorate. The German claims on this land were confirmed during the Conference of Berlin later that same year. The lure of economic possibilities in diamond and mineral mining led to German Southwest Africa becoming Germany's largest settled colony. As the number of settlers increased, relations with the indigenous peoples, the Hottentots, worsened. Numerous uprisings of the Hottentots, beginning in 1893, continued into the early 1900s. Germany then began a genocidal Herero War against all the indigenous peoples. By 1908, all rebellions had been quashed, and many of the surviving Hottentots placed in detention centers. The neighboring British objected to what they regarded as the inhumane German policy. In 1914, South African troops occupied the territory and deposed the German colonial administration. The end of the war and the Treaty of Versailles resulted in Southwest Africa remaining a possession of South Africa as a League of Nations mandate until 1990, when the territory was granted independence as the nation of Namibia. The postal history of the colony began in July 1888 at Atjimbingwe. Cancellations can be found with different spellings of the city name, one with a letter Y and another with a letter J. Known as Vorläufer, these town canceled stamps are the only indication of a German presence at this early date. The service expanded to post offices in Windhoek in 1891, and Swakopmund in 1895. The first colonial stamps consisted of overprints applied to the 1889 German Reichspost issues in 1897, reading Deutsch Südwestafrika at an angle. In 1898, the overprint was changed to Deutsch Südwestafrika, dropping the hyphen. In 1900, both of the Hohenzollern issues were released inscribed with Deutsch Südwestafrika. The last of these was the 3-mark value, printed in 1919, which was never put on sale in the colony. Some values, such as the 3 and 5 Pfennig Hohenzollern, are readily available today. Genuinely used high values of the Hohenzollerns saw very little usage before the colony's end and are considerably more valuable. As a warning to the collector, many of these used stamps are known to have forged cancellations. In all, 34 stamps were issued for German Southwest Africa between 1897 and 1919. No Allied occupational overprints were used. In addition, postal cards were widely available. Numerous types of used postal cards can be readily found. Togo, which in the 1880s was known as Togoland, is in West Africa. Lomé, its capital, is located on the coast of the Gulf of Guinea. Togo is one of the smallest countries in Africa. Togo's coastal region was a major slave trading center for native slave trade, Islamic slave trade, and European slavers. Togo and the surrounding region became known as the Slave Coast. Today, Togo's economy depends on agriculture rather than the slave trade. In 1884, Germany declared a region, including present-day Togo, as a protectorate. Its borders were redefined with agreements reached with Germany's chief rivals, France and Britain. Togo was invaded by Britain and France at the onset of the First World War, proclaiming an Anglo-French partnership. On December 7, 1916, the partnership terminated, with Togo divided into a British and French zone. On July 20, 1922, Great Britain received the League of Nations mandate to govern the western part of Togo, while France received the eastern part. These mandates later became UN Trust territories. In 1945, French Togo joined the French Parliament. British Togo joined the Gold Coast as part of the new nation of Ghana in 1957. Togo gained its independence from France in 1960. Today, Togo covers approximately 22,000 square miles, with a population of approximately 8 million. The first Togo four-lifers were the German 1875-1890 Reichspost Common Design stamps, used at Kleinpopo beginning in 1888 and at Lomé beginning in 1890. Beginning in 1897, 6 German Reichspost Common Design stamps were issued with a Togo overprint. In 1900, 17 Hohenzollern Common Design stamp values were issued and inscribed with Togo, of which 4 values were never released. These remained in use until the First World War. In August 1914, Togo was invaded by British and French troops, who occupied the country until 1919. The German post offices were closed, and the occupying forces initially used German stamps with overprints. Germany issued 23 stamps during its dominion. The British overprinted 34 Hohenzollern issues, while the French overprinted 24 issues. The combined total of 81 stamps provide an ample variety of postal history. The Ottoman Empire emerged in late 13th century Anatolia, which today is the portion of Turkey on the Asian continent. By the 17th century, it controlled much of southeastern Europe, Western Asia, and Northern Africa. Toward the end of the 19th century, the Ottoman Empire had declined to a point where it was referred to as the sick man of Europe. The Ottomans were subject to intense pressure from numerous nations wanting to influence the empire. Germany contended with the Austro-Hungarian Empire Italy, Russia, France, and the Great Britain to sway its leadership. The Ottomans entered World War I on the side of the Central Powers. With their defeat at the end of the war in 1918, most of the Ottoman territories were divided between Britain, France, Greece, and Russia. Turkey was declared a republic in October 1923 with Mustafa Kemal Atatürk at the helm. Philatelically, on March 1, 1870, the Norddeutsche Postbezirk, the postal service of the North German Confederation, opened its first office in Constantinople using definitive stamps without overprints. After German unification, the German Post Office in 1872 took over and expanded it further as the Deutsche Post in der Türkei to include Constantinople and Beirut, Jaffa, Jerusalem, and Smyrna. There are many varieties of these four-lifer issues, and the postmarks and the postal history of this 13-year period can be a philatelic study in itself. In 1884, stamps were issued with overprints that restated the stamps' face values in the Turkish denominations of the piastres and paras. As was the case with all German offices, stamps before 1905 bore a Latin font in several varieties. In 1905, the overprint was changed to a Gothic font that remained in use until the beginning of World War I. In 1908, the Germans issued an additional set of stamps that were sold at the same time as those overprinted in Turkish piastres. This 1908 series had diagonal overprints in French centimes instead of horizontal overprints in Turkish piastres. Turkey's initial neutrality in World War I led to the closure of the German post offices on September 30, 1914. A total of 60 issues were overprinted for the use in Ottoman Empire. Postal history is common and very affordable. European interests in China dates to Marco Polo, the Venetian explorer who completed two expeditions to China in the late 1200s. The age of exploration in the 1500s produced an increase in Western expeditions into Asia and China. Over the next three centuries, many European countries established colonies and trade links around the Macau region. During this time, the Qing dynasty tried to restrict foreign trade to Macau and the surrounding region, though their efforts were largely in vain. In 1757, the Qing introduced the Canton system, requiring foreign companies to trade with a Chinese merchant collective and not directly with the Chinese people. These attempts to limit and control foreign trade activities failed. The British soon became China's largest foreign trading partner. British companies purchased vast amounts of Chinese tea, as well as luxuries like silk, porcelain, and other decorative items, which led to a troubling trade imbalance in China's favor. To help even the trade imbalance, Britain exported larger and larger shipments of opium from India to China. The Qing dynasty was ineffective in stopping the invasions of the foreign devil's drugs, which in the mid-19th century led to two opium wars that China lost. In 1898, the Boxer Rebellion by the Society for Righteous and Harmonious Fists broke out, laying China open to gunboat diplomacy by Germany and seven other nations. The murder of two German missionaries led to an invasion of Tsingtao in the Shandong Peninsula by Germany and its allies. The United States got involved in the fight, with the U.S. Secretary of State John Hay enunciating the open-door policy. Historically, it was considered a fair and equitable rape of China. The continued weakening of the Qing dynasty helped the latecomer Germany to gain a foothold in China with the leasing of the Kiaochow Bay territory in 1898 and the formation of the colony of Kiaochow on the southern coast of the Shandong Peninsula. 200 million marks went into the development of harbor infrastructure. Floating dry docks, ship berths, heavy machinery investments, and rail yards were constructed. Private enterprise worked across the Shandong province, opening mines, banks, breweries, factories, shops, and rail lines. A naval base, a source of raw materials, and a place to sell German goods all contributed to the success of German ambitions. China became an important naval staging area for the German fleet. During World War I, Admiral Count von Spree's 3rd Sea Battalion, based in Tsingtao, serviced all of German Oceania. A minor British naval attack was launched in 1914 on the German concession at Tsingtao. Britain's ally, the Japanese, delivered an ultimatum to abandon the territory. The ultimatum was rejected, followed by Japan's declaration of war on Germany in August 1914. The territory was captured by Japan in November. The Treaty of Versailles in 1919 restored these territories to China. Germany established its first post office at Shanghai in 1886, followed by Tianjin in 1893 and Shifu in 1900. Within the next 5 years, post offices were established along portions of the eastern coastline of China and in the interior of the Shandong and Henan provinces. Offices were opened in Hankou, Peking, Amoy, Canton, Nanking, and 11 other cities. In all, 19 German post offices were established in China. Most remained in operation until the beginning of World War I. Numerous Vorläufer of the Reichspost Kronenadler issue and the Germania issue exist. As precursors to the Hohenzollern series, Kiaochau Vorläufer are usually stamps of the German offices in China and stamps of Germany proper. Plate flaws abound and forged cancellations are prominent on the higher values. Prices are substantial and, buyer beware. In 1898, the Reichspost stamps were overprinted China diagonally. 6 stamps have a 45-degree angled overprint, and 6 have a 56-degree angled overprint. In 1901, the 4 large Reichspost stamps and 9 Germania issue stamps were overprinted China. In 1905, the Hohenzollern series, specific to the Kiaochau colony, was released in 16 values. In 1906 to 1919, 10 stamps were issued with Deutsches Reich in the border and a Gothic China overprint. The German marks and Pfennig values were replaced with Chinese dollars and cents. Chinese postal history of both the colonies and the offices is plentiful, including postcards. A special category of postcards is recognized that consists of postcards graphically showing the beheading of Chinese, Boxer rebels, and the Chinese missionaries. These cards contribute to the anti-Western attitude of the Chinese dynasty and the Boxer rebels that had begun 50 years earlier. These command a premium price. The first European contact with New Guinea was by Portuguese and Spanish sailors in the 16th century. In 1828, the Netherlands claimed the western half of the island as Netherlands New Guinea. In 1883, Australia annexed southeastern New Guinea as British New Guinea. On returning to Germany in 1882 from a 3-year Pacific expedition, Otto Finsch, with the Neue Guinea Company, promoted the expansion of German Empire into the Pacific region. In 1884, Germany claimed northeastern New Guinea and its nearby islands as a protectorate of German New Guinea, also called Kaiser Wilhelmsland. Over the next 2 decades, the protectorate grew to include New Pomerania, later known as New Britain, the Bismarck Archipelago, the Northern Solomon Islands, the Caroline Islands, Palau, the Mariana Islands, the Marshall Islands, and the island of Nauru. The Papua Act of 1905 transferred control of British New Guinea to Australia and renamed British New Guinea to the territory of Papua. Following the outbreak of World War I, Australian troops captured German New Guinea and its outposts. By mandate of the Treaty of Versailles in 1919, the captured territory was placed under control of Australia and became the territory of New Guinea. In 1949, the two territories merged to become the territory of Papua and New Guinea. The first German post offices opened in 1888, using 1875 and 1887 Reichspost stamps. A small number of four-lifers exist. Six Reichspost stamps were issued in 1897, overprinted with a diagonal Deutsche Neuguinea. 13 Hohenzollern stamps with Deutsche Neuguinea in the top banner were issued in 1900. In 1914, four of the Hohenzollern series were reissued with a lozenge watermark. These were printed and sold in Berlin only. Postal history can be found, though it is somewhat scarce and commands a premium price. When the Australians occupied German New Guinea in 1914, they overprinted the existing stock of Hohenzollern issues of New Guinea with GRI, short for Gregorius Rex Imperator, the British King, George V. Values ranged from 1 penny to 5 shillings. Registration labels were also overprinted and pressed into service as 3 pence stamps. The Australians issued overprints in October and December of 1914. In all, the British and Australians produced 50 distinct stamps from the German surplus. Because of the short period of use of the GRI issues, they are scarce and command high prices. The overprinting process produced a number of errors, which also command high prices. German naval operations in China provided for exploration and exploitation of the Pacific in the late 1800s. The Caroline Islands are an archipelago of tiny islands scattered across a distance of 2,200 miles in the western Pacific to the north of New Guinea. They were initially part of the Spanish East Indies governed from Manila. Discovered in the 16th century, Spain basically ignored the islands, allowing German and British poaching after 1870. Following the 1898 Spanish-American War, Spain sold the Caroline and the Northern Marianas to Germany in the German-Spanish Treaty of 1899 for approximately £1 million sterling. Germany governed the archipelago as the Carolinen, associating it with German New Guinea, but postally citing them as the Caroline Islands. With the start of World War I, Japan occupied the islands in 1914 as a partner to the Western powers. In 1920, Japan received a League of Nations mandate over the Caroline Islands. With the end of World War II, the islands became a U.S. Trust Territory. The Caroline Islands changed their name to the Federated States of Micronesia and gained their independence from the United States in 1986. Today, they are divided between the Federated States of Micronesia and Palau in the west. Philatelically, Germany was the only occupational country to issue stamps. In October 1899, German stamps overprinted Carolinen were issued. At first, the overprint was angled at 48 degrees. Then a few months later, the angle was changed to 56 degrees. Few canceled examples of these at either angle survive today. In 1901, Germany issued the Hohenzollern common design stamps inscribed with Carolinen, all with mark and pfennig denominations. In 1905, the stock of 5 pfennig stamps was destroyed in a typhoon, and the 10 pfennig stamps were bisected. Another shortage in 1910 resulted in 3 pfennig stamps surcharged to 5 pfennigs. In all, 26 different postage stamps were released by the Germans. Postal history exists, but is generally quite scarce as covers or postal cards. Governmentally issued postal cards, both mint and used, appear to be more plentiful. The Marianas are an archipelago in the western North Pacific Ocean. Spanish explorers were the first Europeans to arrive. In 1521, Magellan arrived at the islands after his passage through the Strait of Magellan. Spain annexed the archipelago, establishing their capital on the largest island, Guam. The Marianas, and specifically Guam, were a stopover for the Spanish galleons en route from Acapulco to Manila in a convoy known as the Galleon de Manila. The islands were named after the Spanish Queen Mariana of Austria. The islands were a popular port of call for the British and American whaling ships in the 19th century. After the Spanish-American War of 1898, Spain could no longer effectively control the nearly 6,000 islands it possessed throughout the Pacific. In February 1899, Spain entered into the German-Spanish Treaty to sell the Northern Marianas and its other remaining islands to Germany for about $4.2 million. The Northern Marianas and the other island groups were incorporated into the larger German protectorate of New Guinea. Japan, allied with the Western powers during World War I, seized all of Germany's colonial possessions in the Pacific. The Treaty of Versailles in 1919 placed all of them into the trusteeship under the management of the League of Nations, which assigned them to Japan. The Marianas experienced significant fighting during World War II. In 1944, the U.S. captured Saipan and Tinian. Tinian was later to serve as a bombing base to reach Japan. Both the Enola Gay and the Boxcar flew their fateful atomic bombing missions from Tinian in August 1945. The island group came under the control of the United States as the trust territory of the Pacific Islands. The Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands later became a U.S. territory following its exit from the trust territory of the Pacific Islands. They are politically divided into two U.S. jurisdictions, the Commonwealth of the Northern Mariana Islands and the territory of Guam, a U.S. possession since 1898. The German post offices in the Marianas had distinctive issues from the first day of postal operations, so there are no Vorläufer known for this colony. Germany released 37 stamps between 1900 and 1919 for the use in the Mariana Islands. Six Reichspost values were overprinted with Marianen at a 48-degree angle, and six were overprinted at 56 degrees. 15 Hohenzollern with Marianen printed in the banner at the top were also issued with two values never placed in use. Forgeries abound. Postal history exists, but is generally quite scarce. Governmentally issued postal cards, both mint and used, appear to be more plentiful. No stamps were issued by Japan or the United States during their occupations. The Marshall Islands consist of 29 atolls and 5 major islands, totaling about 1,225 islands and 870 reef systems scattered over 750,000 square miles of the Central Pacific. Spain claimed these islands in 1592. The islands derived their names from Captain John Marshall of the Royal Navy, who explored the islands in 1788. In 1885, Spain sold the Marshall Islands to the German Empire. Japan assumed control of the Marshall Islands at the start of World War I. In 1944, during World War II, the U.S. took control of the islands, and in 1947 was awarded the trust territory of the Pacific Islands by the UN Security Council. The Marshall Islands gained their full independence in 1979. The first German post office opened on October 1, 1888, but initially no stamps were available. Contemporary German stamps were placed on sale in March 1889 and can be distinguished as Vorläufers by their postmarks. The first stamps issued for the islands were the 1897 Reichspost overprinted with Marshall Inseln. In 1899, the Reichspost issue was reissued overprinted with Marshall Inseln, with the word Marshall spelled without the letter C. Bisects were also used during this period. In 1901, the Hohenzollern issue was released with Marshall Inseln in the banner at the top of the stamp. Later in 1916, the 3 Pfennig and the 5 Mark stamps were reissued on lozenges, watermark paper, but were only sold in Berlin. In all, 27 stamps were issued by Germany for the use in the Marshall Islands. When the Australian Naval and Military Expeditionary Force occupied German New Guinea in 1914, it met the need for postage stamps by overprinting existing stocks of the Marshall Island stamps with GRI. These overprinted stamps were used for a relatively short period of time, and therefore occur quite rarely and command high prices, in some cases fetching prices over $10,000. Forgeries exist, so buyer beware. In September 1914, Japanese forces occupied the islands of Jaluit. Naval officers broke into the post office and confiscated all German stamp stock and supposedly demonetized and then destroyed it. Overprinted stamps, however, were created by a Japanese naval commander, a Japanese paymaster, and a Japanese ship's physician as curiosities, overprinting the stamps with their own signature seals, known as chops. These items were created on demand for local collectors and must be regarded as bogus stamps with no philatelic value. Postal history can be found, but is somewhat scarce and will usually command a premium price. Samoa consists of 2 main islands, Savai'i and Upulu, and a number of smaller islands. The islands are volcanic and wooded, with Upulu rising to just over 6,000 feet. The natives of Samoa are pure Polynesians, like those of Tahiti and the Hawaiian Islands. The islands were discovered in 1722 by the Dutch admiral Jacob Roggeveen. The Frenchman Bougainville surveyed the islands in 1768. Christian missionary work in Samoa began in 1830 with the arrival of the London Missionary Society. The missionaries were extremely successful. In 1857, J.C. Godefroy and Company of Hamburg chose the island's capital of Apia as their commercial center for the South Pacific. Competition and native unrest led to an agreement in 1899 between Great Britain, Germany, and the United States. Britain renounced her claims, allowing the Germans and the United States to divide the islands between themselves. On March 1, 1900, a flag raising on Upulu inaugurated Samoa as a German colony. The German administration quelled native revolts so they could focus on the island's main economic assets, coconuts and its byproduct, copra fiber. During World War I, New Zealand occupied Apia and was later awarded the islands as a trust territory, both by a League of Nations mandate and later by the United Nations. On January 1, 1962, Samoa became the independent nation of Western Samoa. The first Samoa Vorläufer stamps were the German Reichspost common design stamps used at Apia beginning in 1886. Mail was handled with steamships from Australia, New Zealand, and the United States, with some British assistance. Later, the North German Lloyd Line ran a service to Sydney, Australia, with later connections to Hong Kong. A total of 23 German stamps were used in Samoa. In 1900, 6 stamps were issued with a diagonal Samoa and 13 Hohenzollern stamps inscribed with Samoa. Later, 4 more were prepared with a lozenge watermark, but were never issued. Postal history can be somewhat expensive. With the start of World War I in 1914, the Commonwealth forces overprinted 13 of the Hohenzollern series. The overprints consisted of GRI with pence and shilling denominations. GRI postal history can be found. Forgeries of all overprinted materials are common, so buyer beware.
This brings us to the end of the philatelic overview of Germany's colonies and post offices. At this point, I would like to conclude with a brief summary of the German Empire's demise. The Versailles Treaty of 1919 stigmatized Germany unfairly, blaming the war entirely on the vanquished. We've covered some of the territorial losses of Germany, but there are other areas that we did not include in this presentation. The German printer in the 1920s kept the memory alive by printing the 19 Lost Colonies series, one set perforated, the other set imperforate. Territories that I have not covered are Malmedy and Eupen that went to Belgium, Hulsheiner's Land, which went to the new country of Czechoslovakia, Alsace and Lothringen, Alsace and Lorraine, reverted back to France. Memelan became Lithuania. Schleswig went to Denmark. And Danzig, Posen, and Oberschlesien, Upper Silesia, became Polish. Historic amnesia seems to creep into histories, forgetting about the French monarchy's imperialistic ambitions that 2 centuries later had been forgotten when the Germans reversed the tables. Catholic France sided with the Protestant Swedes to forcibly acquire Alsace and Lorraine for Louis XIV. The provinces of Alsace-Lorraine went back and forth between Germany and France several times. People also forget that the imperial rivalries triggered by the French impacted the Germans in the events such as the 30 Years' War, which devastated 60% of the German inhabitants. The German people's memories were impacted by these events. Beyond the geographic changes of World War I, the viewer also needs to be aware that philatelic forgeries abound throughout this period from 1884 to 1919. With any philatelic endeavor, there are pitfalls. There are reprints, official and not so official. For German offices and colonies, there are forged stamps and forged cancellations. Since 1977, the forger Bernhard Friedrich of Berlin is as well known as the 19th century premier forger Fournier. The Germany Philatelic Society's reference manuals of forgeries is the standard for Mickel catalog users. There are 2 volumes of forgeries dealing with German offices and colonies alone. And for those of you who would like to delve deeper into the subject area, please refer to Albert Friedemann's The Stamps and Cancels of German Colonies and German Post Offices Abroad. For more information about forlifers, you can refer to Dr. Friedrich Steuer's Handbook on Colonial Forlifers. For those of you new to this area of collecting, the U.S. Scots Catalog was used in enumerating the number of stamps cited in this presentation. I would like to repeat once more, buyer beware. There are many areas of philately that we did not include. Transit postmarks, proofs, sayposts, specimens, wartime printings, peacetime printings, and the oddities like wandering cancellations and termite mail. The impetus for this presentation came from Dr. James Paul, a medical doctor with the 5th U.S. Infantry Division during World War II. He witnessed the horrors of German concentration camps as his battalion liberated several camps in the waning days of the war. He created presentations dealing with these issues. I would like to thank the Denver Germany Stamp Club for their assistance in providing material. The club meets every second Wednesday evening at the Rocky Mountain Philatelic Library in Denver. Also, my thanks to the Rocky Mountain Philatelic Library for their support of the Denver Germany Stamp Club and their assistance in the production of this video. In particular, my contributions, together with those of Sergio Lugo, the magic of Joe Lenote, considerably expanded the efforts of Dr. Paul. I encourage investigating this area further and becoming a true philatelist. Have fun and thank you for your time. Please stay tuned for our next presentation on Zeppelins. Deutschland, Deutschland.